Standard Chartered's visiting chief of investments urges a closer focus on the dollar for emerging markets like the Philippines. Steve Bry spoke to ANC Wednesday. He says a continued weakening of the greenback could be good for both equities and bonds in smaller markets. Bryce also believes this could help set the timing for the Philippine Central Bank to begin cutting its rates by the second quarter.
Dollar is a critical variable. So we've obviously seen massive EM underperformance for the past 10, 15 years from an equity market perspective. In terms of the Philippines, the macro story looks pretty positive, right? So from a growth perspective, we're looking at 6% growth this year. So a modest acceleration on what we saw last year and inflation coming down as well. So that should allow the central bank to start cutting rates in the second quarter, in our opinion. And that should be a bit of a tailwind for the market. Valuations here are not stretched. So you can see that strong economic growth should translate to earnings growth.
The Securities and Exchange Commission issues a cease and desist order against several entities using the name of Ayala Corporation. Among those listed in the SEC's order, Ayala Corporation Group Incorporated, Ayala Corporation Budgetarian Online Shop, and Global Ayala or Online Ayala Corp. The SEC said these entities are unlawfully soliciting investments from the public. The commission also prohibited those groups from transacting any businesses involving funds in its depository banks. The Bogus Ayala Group had been conducting an unregistered investment scheme offering online tasks to investors in exchange for commissions. For corporate stories, Ayala Group's renewable energy arm, ASEN, secures a $150 million Australian dollar green term loan. The Australian and New Zealand Banking Group and the Westpac Banking Corporation said. Now, each bank will provide ASEN with a facility limit of $75 million with a four-year tenor. ASEN says the loan will bolster the company's efforts to expand its renewable energy project pipeline in Australia. Earnings reports now from some stock market heavyweights. SM Investments Corporation sees a 25% jump in full-year net income. It climbed to 77 billion pesos in 2023 from 61.7 billion the year before that. Consolidated revenues also up to over 616 billion pesos, higher by 11% year on year. The C family's banking business was the main driver of profit, chipping in 47%, followed by property, retail, and portfolio investments. Over now to real estate, where Mega World of Andrew Tan hit a record 19 billion peso net income last year. This was up by 26% with net income attributable to the parents' shareholders at 17 billion. Consolidated revenues also jumped to near 70 billion pesos. Next to Philinvest Land, net income attributable to equity holders of the parent was up 30%. Or from 2.89 billion pesos in 2022 to 3.77 billion pesos last year. Consolidated revenues and other income, meanwhile, climbed to 22.55 billion pesos. Finally, the Consunyi's mining firm Semirara caps the year in the red. Consolidated net income dropped by 30% to near 28 billion pesos from the 40 billion in 2022. Still, Semirara says coal investments and shipments, as well as electricity sales, helped cushion the blow of subdued coal and power prices.